Good afternoon, folks. Happy Sunday. Happy Mother's Day. Jason Tradesman Outdoor Adventures here for another weekly Big Dude Running blog entry. So this is week two, the Hal Higdon Couch to 50K plan. And I'm going to label this week like any progress is still progress. I got done what I had to get done, but I didn't get done the way I wanted to get done. So I don't want to keep talking about stress because everybody has stress and life challenges. And you know, we talk a lot about, it's not about keeping motivation every day because you're not going to be able to keep motivation every day. It's about being disciplined. And so this week was about kind of just gutting through a lot of things just to get the miles in, get the lifts in, and hopefully to make some slow but steady progress. So this week, the plan called for me to have a total of 18.8 miles. So that's less than what I've had before, but I'm gonna kind of trust the plan. Those were, sorry, three runs this week. Two each on Tuesday and Thursday, 5 miles each, just like, they call them base runs. I talked about that last week as well. So those were pretty straightforward, weren't too bad. And then I had an 8.8 mile run yesterday, Saturday. So that's my weekly long run. And I had kind of hoped that it would have gone better, to be honest. I think part of my issue is I may not be doing enough hill work during the week, and I don't know if I do a lot of my base runs or weekday runs on a treadmill at the gym, because I know I can set the time and just run. And I don't have to worry about the weather. I don't have to worry if it's light out or dark out. And maybe that's like running with the easy, on easy mode. Because on Saturday, I think what I and maybe others have challenges with is trying to find that pace. So I don't live in a super hilly area, but there are hills. And while I'll set an incline on the treadmill when I'm running during the week, I think I leave too fast. And I just felt really kind of gassed this Saturday. Part of the issue was, unfortunately, the aforementioned life stress. I'm having to put my grandma, she's 99, in a home. There's a lot of drama, she doesn't want to go. So I knew I was going to have to drive up to Pennsylvania right after I finished my run. So I was very kind of distracted. I didn't eat before I ran. So kind of a lot of dumb rookie mistakes, but I have to stop, which I guess, stop own-goaling yourself, Jason. So I just need to kind of figure out, I think this is a problem. I'd be curious if others are having this issue. Like you're having, like, it doesn't seem like you're making a lot of obvious progress and you're trying to figure out why, and it could be one variable, it could be a bunch of variables. I just need to get to the bottom of it. Was it, did I not eat right on the run? So anyways, the run was fine. It's pretty rare that I have to stop and walk for a little bit, but I've got a pretty steady climb up to a lake nearby that I run around. It's about a 4¾, 5 mile loop. So I'll do an out and back, and that ends up being pretty close to 9 miles. And I think I just left too hard, didn't fuel properly, didn't get enough sleep, and kind of, I hit my time target, but it wasn't the time target that I wanted to. So anyways, that was this week. We got the miles in, 18.8, felt light, but we got it done. Weights, I moved my leg session. So I'm still doing the three lifting sessions a week, lower body, upper body, and then a core rear chain workout. So I moved the weights up earlier in the week so my legs would be a little bit stronger for the long run day, which does not seem to have panned out in this case. So I did lower body on Tuesday, upper body on Friday, and then core workout was today, Sunday. So I think what I'm gonna try to do is do like a Monday, Wednesday lifting. And that gives my body plenty of time to recover before a long run on Saturday. My weight has not changed this week, which is kind of a bummer. Wasn't super on point with the diet. I just need to get back to like really focusing on macros. I need to like this discipline that I was talking about before. I just got to get it done. So that's my goal for this week, to get that scale moving again in the right direction. This is going to be a big week for me. So I have a total of, according to the plan, 28 miles this week. And so part of that, a good chunk of that, is going to be the Marine Corps Historic Half Marathon in Fredericksburg, Virginia on Sunday. So I'm gonna try to get my lifting done early in the week. I'm gonna try to focus on sleep, get those base building runs in, really try to kind of rest on Saturday so I can give it the beans on Sunday. So my goal is to improve and set a PR for my half marathon time, which I think is like, I had PR about a decade ago that was 140s, I think. My PR right now, I think, is 217 or 212. I'd like to knock that down by 5 or 10 minutes. We'll see if I can. So this week, just again, even though I've said it before, really want to focus on diet, focus on sleep, mitigate stress when I can, although that's not in my control, and just put the miles in. I think it's also getting time for me to get a new pair of shoes. I'm having a lot more foot pain, but I've got about 275 miles on what have otherwise been some pretty outstanding Hoka Arahis. So hopefully, maybe this week we'll get some new shoes. I'll maybe literally put a spring back in my step. And I look forward to coming back to you next Sunday with some maybe a more chipper update. Not chipper, more devil in the details, positive movement update next Sunday. So I hope you're enjoying Mother's Day. I hope the weather is as beautiful where you are as it is here. 70 and sunny, not too humid. And I look forward to catching up with you soon. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and comment, please. Have a good one.